Okay, so everybody here is of a decent age, but other people aren't. So I just wanted to go back and talk about what HIV was like at the beginning, because people forget what it was like and the fear that happened at the beginning. So basically, the epidemic started in 81 when the first cases were noticed. There were actually cases before that, and the gay community was aware of it, but not the greater population. And people don't realize now, when it came out, that no one knew what AIDS came from. It was total mystery. Okay, something never seen before in history. And there was a lot of talk about it was something from the gay lifestyle, God's punishment, something, the drugs the gay guys were using. And there was this whole kind of party scene where they're using a lot of drugs, so they weren't sure. So basically, AIDS hit the main press in 81, and the term AIDS was developed in 83, and the virus, HIV, was not discovered till 84 or 85, depending on who you believed. Luc Montagnier at the Pasteur Institute discovered it, but people didn't really believe him. And then this guy Gallo at the National Institutes of Health in the States found it, and everybody believed him, and they went with it. And in the end, they shared co-discovery. So both institutes, the National Institutes of Health, National Institutes of Health in the States, and the Pasteur Institute in Paris, share royalty payments on every HIV test performed in the world. And people think that the major market is for testing people. Actually, the major market is testing blood. So every time they draw blood, the Red Cross or whatever agency does it, they test it with these tests, and that's the major market. And actually, the tests are kind of developed that way to be highly, highly sensitive. So that's also what leading to a lot of false positives. So the basic theory of HIV, because something as awful and icky as AIDS could not come from us, was that it came from over there, and it was from Africa. And the idea, it was something like when the Europeans came to the Americas in the 1500s, and they brought the germs over from Europe that the Indians in South America had never experienced, and we decimated the population, they all died from these new diseases. That was the theory about HIV. It was came out of the jungle, and maybe people in the jungle were used to the virus, but when it came to the urban populations of Africa, these naive populations were infected and died from the disease. And basically, there were 50, 100, 150 million Africans who were infected and dying before it was noticed, and the first gay guys in New York were getting it. That's kind of the theory. And of course, it came from monkeys, where it crossed over into humans 1, 2, 3, a dozen times, going back to 1930 or whatever. This is kind of the story that's been sold. And there's a bunch of issues here. I think there was a lot of psychological and economic and financial imperative to try to find the source from over there, because in 81 was also the burgeoning time of the biotechnology industry. Okay, so a lot of people still think it's a laboratory virus, either intentional or accidental. So it was just kind of nice that people wanted to believe it's from over there and not from the fact that we've been pouring viruses down the sink when we should have done other things or stuff like that. So I think this is why. People just want to place this thing. And also, it was a very, very uncomfortable, very awful disease. People were dying horrific deaths. And you know, just couldn't be, just had to be something from somebody else, not from us. So there's a strong psychological imperative not to look for the cause locally. And people also forget that, you know, they were predicting that entire African nations would die out. Like Botswana was supposed to die out entirely, okay? And perhaps a third of the African population was going to die off. Never happened. Rather, from 1681, where the population of Africa was supposedly 600 million, to around 2000 or 2010, I'm not sure, the population of Africa was 900 million. So it increased by a third, although AIDS is supposed to be decimating all of Africa. And the theory that AIDS came from Africa, it was actually a comedy of errors. The first step was when African blood was brought over to Harvard School of Public Health from African monkeys, the blood samples were contaminated by a virus that came from Massachusetts. And it's an AIDS-like virus. And when they looked in the blood samples, they found this AIDS-like virus. They said, oh my God, AIDS is from monkeys in Africa. Okay, the contamination, that was 85. The contamination was not discovered until 88, but by then, they had just found a half a dozen other viruses in African monkeys, and the story was flowing. So it was too late. But the basic theory that HIV comes from Africa was caused by an incident of laboratory contamination at the Harvard School of Public Health. That's how it started. Okay, and it's gone from there for various reasons. And other stories. Laboratory contamination has had kind of a lot of play in the AIDS arena. There was a story back in the 90s, I think, about a seaman, a sailor from Manchester, England, who had AIDS in 1959, because he'd gone to Africa in 1959 and he died of AIDS. There's a kind of this hysteria about AIDS. There are over 130 genetic conditions that cause immunodeficiency. Okay, so when you go back in the literature and you find, oh, here's a guy who had, looks like it was AIDS, and here's one over here, they instantly say, oh, that's AIDS. But it could be any number of these genetic conditions, or it could be a cancer, like a leukemia, that destroys the blood cell, blood population. So there's this kind of hysteria where they always look back and find something, and they, oh, that's AIDS, they put together these, they weave the story together of all these historical AIDS cases. So this guy from Manchester, England, the story is, he never sailed south of Gibraltar. And they actually went and they had samples of his blood and they found the HIV virus in it. But then, whoops, well, it just seemed as though it might possibly be laboratory contamination. Okay, and this is a problem in the lab. And this is a problem with police labs. For instance, here you have the sample from the crime scene. And here you have the sample from the person you think did the crime. And you bring in, oh! Okay, sure, boss, I'll have it ready tomorrow. Happens all the time. A lot of times, not all the time, but it happens that you have the sample from the crime scene, from the African monkey or whatever, you bring in a sample to compare it with, and you contaminate the sample with what the comparator. Okay, and this happens frequently. Okay, so when you have these laboratories, supposedly in the crime labs, they should have protocols and techniques and experience, do it all the time, they should have it under control. But when you have all these individual professors or researchers in their laboratories who are doing things ad hoc and making things up as they go and doing things the first time, it's even more likely. So it's always a question. When you get these results that just don't make sense, it's always a question, is it just cross-contamination of laboratory equipment? And it's not that they trip like this, the problem is the laboratory equipment is contaminated. That's the problem. And when I first wrote the first book, it was funny because I talked to a major cancer research facility in Boston. They get all this money. I used to go in the movie theaters and there'd be an ad saying, oh, donate to this cancer, this cancer group, this cancer research center. And I talked to this guy on the phone, and you know, I sound nervous today, but they know what I'm talking about. And he goes, yeah, you know, you never really know what you're growing because there's so much cross-contamination with the equipment in the laboratory. Okay, so that's a problem. But, and I don't want to cast aspersions on everybody, but it's a possibility. It's a possibility and something always to consider when you have results that don't make sense.